Subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon and never miss an update from Latestly.
You cannot replicate the magic of a live performance anywhere else in the world. What is stopping theater from going online, you know? In the last 15 years, I have missed out on close to 150 odd shows or plays. I haven't marketed myself well, and that is my drawback. You give someone money, you feed him for a day, but you give someone work and you feed him for life.
Shreyas Tatpadey, thank you so much for joining us, first of all, on Latestly. And we are here to talk about a new venture that has created, I hear, more than 1,500 jobs. And this is an exclusive OTT platform, yeah, which is dedicated to theater and performing arts exclusively in a variety of languages. And you have whatnot. You have stand-up comedies, you have plays, full-length plays, you have poetry, documentary, everything. In a range of languages, primarily now, yeah, Marathi, Hindi, English, and Gujarati. And but you're also planning to go ahead with Punjabi, Tamil, as well as various South languages.
Bengali. Bengali. Malayalam,
yeah. Yes, yes. So yeah, how are you doing this? I mean, this seems to be a bigger vision, a broader vision.
Yeah, as in it, and like you just asked me, how am I doing it? I guess I figured that, you know, we've been hearing about this saying for a long time, mm-hmm, where there's a will, there's a way.
Absolutely.
This time, probably I got an opportunity, and I think I also had a fantastic, have a fantastic team with me to pull off this particular vision. So it started with a simple intention to help out the theater community in this pandemic. Mm-hmm. So last March, April, around same time, you know, we started getting calls from friends that what should we do for the theater community, the actors, technicians, directors, writers, because theaters are shut, like auditoriums are shut. So what do we do? Where do they perform? How do they get their daily, whatever, incomes and things like that? So that is the time when we started thinking, what should we do? And there's this saying that, you know, you give someone money, you feed him for a day, but you give someone work and you feed him for life. So we thought that we should try and do something more than just provide monetary help. And that is all. That was also the time when everything was going online, you know, so education was going online, fitness online, cooking online, obviously films and things were also there online. So I said, then why should theater not go online? I mean, what is stopping theater from going online? You know, when there is, and the more we researched about it, we figured that there are millions of people worldwide who miss theater and who want to see theater in some form or the other. It's like, there are some plays that happen here in Mumbai. Even in Mumbai, most of the times, you are not able to go and catch a particular play because it's probably playing at 4 o'clock in an auditorium which is not near your place. You might have the time, but it's due to go and travel. Mm. It's not like films, right? Ki 3 baje ka show miss ho gaya, toh 3:30, 4:15, 4 ka dekh liya. Waisa nahi ho sakta. So then if you miss it out, you tend to miss it out. You know, and in that process, personally, me also, in the last 15 years, I have missed out on close to 150 odd shows or plays that must have, you know, opened in various forms. So I figured if there is such a huge demand and right now the idea is to help them out, why not collect content, shoot it and have a platform which will be just dedicated to theater and performing arts, you know.
And this is, nothing, this is more than 100 hours of original content we're talking about.
Is what we have right now. Of course, that will come on the platform in a phased manner. Not all of it is coming together on the platform because we've shot it. Now we're editing it. So what we do is when we shoot a particular play, we try and maintain the whole sanctity and purity of theater intact. But when we do the post-production, we try to treat it like a film. So after shooting, we do online edit, then offline edit, then background score, then mixing, then DI, grading, everything. And then we try and upload it. So, of course, that is something that is taking time. Also, with, you know, certain restrictions in place, things are a little slower than what they would have been. So, yes, all that content is pretty much ready and it is, you know, in the process of being uploaded one after the other. So, what I did, Prathamesh, was very simple. You know, this thing became what it is today. You know, we launched today and the kind of response, touch wood, that we are generating is phenomenal. I mean, it is definitely more than what we expected, considering we've only been, you know, speaking about it from March 27th when we first released our teaser. Mm. So the response is pretty touchwood phenomenal, and we are hoping that it keeps growing by leaps and bounds. But I'm just taking one day at a time, as simple as that. You know, just one day at a time, do what you have right now, move on to the next. And then automatically, if you have the vision and the intention, then things will shape up.
For someone who has done theater extensively, what is your assessment of the palette of theater? And I'm asking this question to you because, first of all, in order to have the content ready, you have to create a palette. Do you think that there is a palette ready amongst the new generation, the generation Y, so to speak, who have content readily available on their mobile phone in terms of other OTT platforms, in terms of what they get on streaming platforms? So is there burning desire for them to also first know what theater is, the nuances of the theater, its impact, and then perhaps hold on to it? What is your assessment?
You know, the best thing about the millennials, if we talk about them, is they are aware, they are well informed, and they take their own decisions. You know, I mean, this was something that probably growing up, I kind of lacked, taking my own decision, because I would always ask someone, my elder brother, my parents, or, you know, my uncles, kya karun, aisa karun, vaisa karun, arre ye karna, ye course karna. We were always told, ye karna, vaisa karna. These guys, you don't need to tell them anything. They know most of the things and they decide for themselves. And they tell you, okay, this is it. So I think that is the best part about them. What they need is, and what we need to give them is good quality content, period. So if they like it, they lap it up and how. And we've seen that, right? I mean, we've seen with the whole, bursting of this whole OTT thing in this last year and the kind of content consumption that happens with the millennials. If they like a particular thing, you cannot stop that content from going viral. So I'm not worried about that. I, of course, to begin with, the TG is someone who loves theater, who misses theater, and who wants to catch theater in some way or the other. Okay. So, of course, there are going to be certain people who will say theater is only supposed to be performed live, and, you know, you have to go to the auditorium and check it, and it's a completely different experience. For someone from theater, I've done like 15, 18 years of theater. I completely agree that, yes, you cannot replicate the magic of a live performance anywhere else in the world. You cannot. Having said that, not everyone is as privileged to go and see that particular play at that point in time. So what happens to those people? And why should that production or those actors or that writing material be away from all those people who want to consume it? So that is where I'm coming from. So there will be people who would want to see it initially. And if they like the content, obviously there's going to be a word of mouth that will spread and people will come for that content. It is exactly like how we treat films. So when we are releasing a film, we are not sure who's going to come and how they're going to react, right? But we want more and more people to come. It's only when they like it, there's word of mouth and the film grows.
Exactly. So would it be fair to say, just like we are missing out on cinematic experience, people are also missing out on theatrical experience. And you are giving them exactly that via this platform.
Well, theater, yes. I mean, definitely people are missing out on the theater without a doubt. And that is exactly what I'm trying to fill in the gap in a way. So, but of course, even I have certain limitations. There's certain limited content that I have. But I'm trying to give them whatever best content possible from my end, you know. So, and this whole idea of, for the longest time, we have tried to intellectualize theater. I don't know why. Because, you know, even a street play is theater, Ram Leela is theater, and auditorium is also theater. Why unnecessarily intellectualize it and set it up on a pedestal where a common man thinks that, nahi yaar, theater matlab baapre. Aisa nahi hai. It is as entertaining and as pure, as rich, and as amazing an art form as anything else. You know, people, there have been so many people who said, yeah, we used to go and watch theater, but then we started growing up, we started getting busy in other things, and then we couldn't go. So I said, so do you blame theater for that, or do you blame the non-availability of time? He said, no, theater remains the same. You know, theater is great. It's just that we couldn't go. But now with this, probably we have a chance that we'll watch all those plays because we love watching theater. I mean, you see the kind of response that we're getting on our social media for this whole thought of, you know, bringing theater to their living rooms. It is phenomenal.
In the past few years, we have seen you on OTT platform. We have seen you portraying a range of characters as well. Why don't we see you more often in cinemas these days? And also, while the Nawazuddin Siddiqui's of the world or the Pankaj Tripathi's of the world get a chance or get characters to play that are pretty impressive, what is holding Shreyas Tarpade back is a larger question.
I don't know. I really don't know. You know, probably for some people, I must have gone off the radar. So it's not that who would not want to do films? Would not want to play some excellent characters, you know? And today, especially with this whole newer generation of filmmakers coming in, everybody's playing a character. There's no longer this hero, heroine, vagara, funda. You know, it's a character that everybody's playing. So I don't know. I mean, if people, you know, want me to play a particular character in their part, I'm more than happy to play that in that film. But I'm also, Prathamesh, I'm not the one who would probably try and sell himself. You know, I'm one of those ki, I have always, my gurus or my training has been such that aapka kaam aapko aur kaam dega. You know, so aap achha kaam karo, aap imandari se kaam karo, to aapko achha aur kaam milega. So I have not, you know, the only thing that I have lacked in my entire career, and I don't regret it, is the whole marketing part of it. I haven't marketed myself well, and that is my drawback. So I'm not the one who would probably call up producers or directors and tell them, "Arey, wah, sir, kya baat hai? Agla kuch bhi hoga, to please mujhe batai." Somehow, I don't know. Matlab, maybe there's nothing wrong in it. There's nothing wrong in calling and telling people that you want to work with them. It's just that somehow the way I'm groomed as an actor, I always feel that no, if they like my work, you know, they will tell me. You know, so it's coming from there. So yes, I am open to doing a lot more films, a lot more characters. And like you said, I love what Nawaz Bhai and Pankaj Bhai are doing, you know, and we really, really miss Irfan Bhai because one of the finest actors. So we really miss him. But these guys are doing great, and you know, it would be great to share screen with all of them for that matter. Manoj Bhai, some super performances he's doing.
Shreyas, in that case, is there something in particular that you're looking at, particular genre, particular actor, director, particular platform? And in future, are you going to polish your marketing skills?
Well, I am trying to work on my marketing skills for sure. You know, but and it's always better late than never. So, of course, I won't say that I'll never do that. Yes, there are certain drawbacks that I have, and it's always better that you understand what your drawbacks are and you work towards it. But if you ask me about any particular director, actor, producer, I have somehow I've shared a great rapport with most of my directors, whether it is Nagesh Kuknur or Rohit Shetty, Farah Khan, Sadiq Khan, Shyam Babu, Sangeet Sivan. I have enjoyed working with all of them. So I think right now I'm looking at some meaty roles. In fact, some negative kind of character. You know, I've done some serious films.
You want to explore the gray zone, or yeah, life as is, or the life as is.
Yeah, you can say that, but but yeah, that is something that I am personally looking forward to playing.
Coming back to Nine Rasa, is there something that you want to explore through this? Is there something that you're pretty sure that you will learn from this platform and would implement the lessons that you might learn from this platform in your cinematic journey, in your theater journey, or in your OTT platform journey?
No, learn, of course I will. There have been a lot of learning lessons in this past 1 year when we were working on this platform. And, you know, also probably we could have launched it a little earlier, but again, I was a little scared, nervous, because such a huge thing coming out. I just wanted to be completely sure. But yeah, there are certain things that will remain. We will be doing certain mistakes. Not that we are pros at it, you know. So of course, there will be certain mistakes that will happen. And we would want our audience to tell us where to improve, how to improve, what is the content that they're looking at. And I think that in itself is a great learning lesson, right? Because you need to listen to the feedback that you're getting. Someone once told me that more than being a great speaker, you got to be a great listener. And you should be open to suggestions. True. So I'm completely open to that. Like you just mentioned, why aren't you doing films? So yes, I mean, you know, similarly, I would like to have feedback from my people who feel for me, who really wish well for me. I would like them to tell me what they want me to do and how they want me to do it. And I'm a performer. I'm an artist. I'm here for them, for my audience. So whatever they need me to do, I will try.
The reason why I quizzed you on that, just before this interview, I was having this conversation with a friend of mine, and he said, Shreyas is belongs to that zone, and the names that we mentioned, say Nawaz Bhai or Pankaj Bhai. And yet, this is not an age where you shine just as larger than life hero. OTT platforms are booming, mushrooming, so much quality content, and we are missing his talent. We are missing him in that zone because he's got that range, he's got those things and those skills in his repertoire, and still the question, why not? So that was the honest space from which that question came from. And also,
well, I'm glad, you know, Prathamesh, to be very honest, it is pretty humbling, because if someone thinks of me like that, then I please thank him on my behalf. Yeah. Thank your friend, because it's very important that it's when your audience thinks that you're done, then there's nothing you can do. But if your audience feels that, you know, we want to see more of him, then there's definitely a chance.
Quality is what you have always been associated with. In fact, Shreyas Tharpade is synonymous with quality content. So in that sense, quality will be the primary major factor on this platform as well. And what would be the business model be like?
So quality, definitely no compromising on quality at all. The idea is to have theater in all its forms. Commercial theater, mass theater at the same time, experimental theater, theater with some new guys, theater with some seniors, all sorts of theater with set, without set. So that is what we are trying to achieve through various content pieces that we have. So yes, quality, maximum effort will be on the fact that the quality is not compromised. That's the reason I said that we shoot it keeping the sanctity of theater intact, but we treat it like a film. Similarly, it is a completely family, family app, you know, so the entire family can very easily, without any inhibitions, you know, watch it. You can have your laptop open or your desktop open and you can watch a play on speaker without bothering about who's watching and whether there's anything else coming in. So no issues whatsoever. And the pricing is, I think very, very reasonable. It's 59 rupees a month and 599 rupees a year. There are only two plans, monthly and yearly. So 59 a month and 599 a year.
Yeah. Here's my last question. And since most of the people in India, we as Marathi audience know you, the kind of plays you have done, the kind of Marathi movies you have done. But India in general, so to speak, they associate you with two big films, which is of course Om Shanti Om, starring Shah Rukh Khan, and of course the one that you did with, of course, Nagesh Kapoor, co-starring Nasiruddin Shah. So tell us, I mean, when you see, and these two actors also are not seen these days much, be it OTT or cinema, Nasiruddin Shah as well as Shah Rukh Khan. What are your fond memories of working with them?
So all three of us need to pull up our socks in shorts.
Absolutely. Absolutely. One is a superstar and one is a super actor. And these roles could be interchangeable in their own right, but I am putting them in major category that way. So what are your fond memories? Immediate strike.
A lot of fond memories. You know, Iqbal, I remember almost every single day. Right from the day when I was selected to the day when I came back home, to when I used to go for the sound mixing sessions of Iqbal, to when it was released, to when I went for screenings of Iqbal, to, you know, kids coming in. I mean, there were a lot of screenings for schools that happened for Iqbal. And then I went for, in fact, I was just narrating someone one incident where there was this young kid some, I think, 8-9 standard kid who came to me after one of the screenings of Iqbal, you know, and said, "Bhaiya, bhaiya, I love the film and, you know, I want to become a doctor. And this film has inspired me so much, I am going to become a doctor." So I said, "Wow, wow, wow, great, great, great." Everything happened. Then suddenly, you know, cut to 12, 13 years later, one guy walks up to me and he says, "Hello, sir, you won't recognize me. I met you after one of the screenings of Iqbal and I told you that I am going to become a doctor. Today, I am a doctor."
Wow.
I cannot tell you how fulfilling that whole experience was. Because one film, you do one part in a film and that film inspires someone to go out there and achieve his dreams, I think is phenomenal. And similarly, Om Shanti Om with Shah Rukh. I think Shah Rukh is not only a superb actor, but also a great film businessman, I must say. Because the way he visualizes his production, the way he visualizes the whole mounting of his film, the publicity, the marketing, the release, the launch, the everything is phenomenal. It's something so much to learn from that person. He's so passionate about the entire thing that he wouldn't really think twice about making sure that this is my film. This is the biggest. In fact, when we were shooting Om Shanti Om, I very vividly remember this, that, you know, these were his lines, that Shreyas, you know what? I want Om Shanti Om to be the biggest film of 2007, period. You know, so this was the vision that he had. And I think he has been living that kind of dream ever since. So I really admire him for everything that he's not only achieved, but whatever he's taught me unknowingly as well.
Yes, yes. And of course, Iqbal inspired me to wherever I am in my small capacity is the larger portion of it. And the credit, of course, goes to Iqbal, the way it motivated us, the way it pushed us. And Ashai was one of the major track that I used used to listen to whenever I felt low. And that always inspired me to bounce back.
Thank you.
Shreyas Tatpate, thank you so much for your time. Thank you so much for giving us a platform as unique as yours, Nine Rasa, that will thank help you. People to explore the various facets of theater, various facets of performing arts. Thank you so much for your lovely answers. Thank you so much for your time. All the best.
Thank you. Thank you, Prathamesh. Lovely chatting with you too. You take care and take care of yourself. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Stay safe.
Yes, you too.